Mercutio from Romeo and Juliet by William Shakespeare. Thou art like one of these fellows that when he enters the confines of a tavern, claps he his sword upon the table and says, God send me no need of thee, and by the operation of the second cup draws him on the drawer when indeed there is no need. Come, come, thou art as hot a jack in thy mood as any in Italy, and as soon moved to be moody and as soon moody to be moved. Nay, and there were two such, we should have none shortly, for one would kill the other. Thou wilt quarrel with the man for cracking nuts, having no other reason but because thou hast hazel eyes. What eye but such an eye would spy out such a quarrel? Thy head is full of quarrels as an egg is full of meat, and yet thy head has been beaten as addle as an egg for quarreling. Thou hast quarreled with a man for coughing in the street because he hath wakened thy dog but had lain asleep in the sun. Didst thou not fall out with a tailor for wearing his new duck before Easter, with another for tying his new shoes with old ribbon? And yet thou wilt tutor me from quarreling. By my heel, I care not. Our course will seem too bloody, Caius Cassius, to cut the head off that and hack the limbs like wrath and death and envy afterwards. For Antony is but a limb of Caesar. Let's be sacrifices, but not butchers, Caius. We all stand up against the spirit of Caesar, and in the spirit of men there is no blood. Oh, that we then could combine Caesar's spirit and not dismember Caesar. But alas, Caesar must bleed for it. And, gentle friends, let's kill him boldly, but not wrathfully. Let's carve him as a dish before the gods, not hew him as a carcass fit for hounds. And let our hearts, as subtle masters do, stir up their servants to an act of rage, and after seem to chide them. This shall make our purpose necessary and not envious, which so appearing to the common eyes, we'll be called perjurers, not murderers. As for Mark Antony, think not of him, for he can do no more than Caesar's arm when Caesar's head is off.